So what actually is a blueprint? If you're a beginner with Unreal Engine, it can be pretty hard to understand what it is. Is it a class, a function, a script? And what does making a blueprint of something actually mean? I mean, there are animation blueprints, level blueprints, blueprint interfaces. What are they? By the end of this video, you'll have answers to all of these questions and more. And with the newly acquired knowledge of blueprints, let's blow up this statue at the end of the video. So you might have heard that blueprints are this cool visual scripting tool of Unreal, and we don't need to write a single line of code. But what exactly is it? When you search the normal definition of blueprint on Google, it says a design plan or other technical drawing. It's basically a design for making something, and that is exactly what a blueprint is. In a programmer's perspective, Unreal Engine is object-oriented, which means everything in the game is an object. And each of these objects have a parent class, and these objects mimic the properties of those parent classes. This is called inheritance. When you try to make a new blueprint class, you're prompted to pick the parent class. There are many classes to pick as a parent class, but the most common ones are listed here. And with the class as a parent, we make a blueprint. Here you can see the parent class, and if you click on that, you can see the actual code of that class. So here we can add different components to our blueprint, which adds different functionality. For example, with the static mesh component, we can add a mesh. And with the collision component, we can detect collisions and so on. At the side, there is the event graph. And this is where the actual visual scripting is done. This is where we define the logic for the blueprint using these boxes called nodes. There are several types of nodes. There are utility nodes like branch, for each loop. Then there are function nodes, which take in inputs and give the required outputs. The inputs are often called parameters. And there are also event nodes, which are the starting blocks of all blueprints. For example, the event begin play node runs as soon as you begin playing the level. Then there are also get functions, which are used to get information about something. Each of these nodes does something, and we can even make custom events. We can use these nodes in different combinations to build logic for these blueprints, just like writing code. Except with blueprints, you don't need to worry about the insanely verbose syntax of C++ and wait ages for code to compile, which is why you can work so much faster using blueprints. But C++ is compiled into a format which is easier for the computer to understand, while blueprints will have to be interpreted through a virtual machine. So yeah, C++ is still C++. Now let's make this statue go boom. But before that, if you got any value from this video, please consider leaving a like and subscribe, as it helps me out tremendously. So I'm using this Japanese statue which I downloaded from Fab. I'll leave a link to download this if you want to follow along. So let's drag it into our viewport and adjust a little bit. Now, to break this statue, we need to fracture it first. We can do that by going into the fracture mode and creating a geometry collection component. If we scroll down, we can see all the different ways we can fracture the mesh. Let's select uniform, internal material, let's set the same material as the mesh, and fracture. Now our mesh is fractured. We can visualize it using this explode amount setting. And if we press play, as you can see, it won't break into pieces. And the reason for that is, if we go into the details of the geometry collection component and see the damage threshold, you can see the damage required to break the mesh is really high, and simply falling won't do it. So let's reduce it. And now, the mesh breaks, but you can see the internal material is not applied properly. To set that, let's go to the utilities tab inside the fracture mode. And in materials, let's add a material slot and then select the material. We can use the explode amount to see and assign materials. And now for making the explosion, select our statue and click on this icon to make it into a blueprint class. Let's name it Boom. So this is our blueprint. Let's go into the event graph and delete these two nodes. So the logic will be simple. We need to add an impulse to our statue, then spawn a particle effect and a sound at the same location. We take the geometry collection component and add impulse. Then let's add a small delay. And then let's spawn emitter at location and then place sound at location. For these two nodes, we also need to specify the location. So let's get actor location and feed it to both of them. For the impulse, let's add 3000 in the Z axis. And for the particle effect, let's select the explosion from the starter content. And sound, explosion. So yeah, that's all there is to make this statue go explode. That is going to be it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section and I'll answer to all of them. Next, watch this video and comment your genius game idea. I'll see you there. Until next time.